A simple but effective way to visualize your results are main effect plots and interaction plots. And if you're looking for more advanced visualization techniques, you can use counterplots and 3D plots. Hey, my name is Marcel. I have a PhD in chemical engineering, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create these plots with Python. And since I'm lazy, I'm going to have my AI assistant helping out with writing the code. Check the link in the video description if you want to follow along. Let's get started. And first things first, we need to get our data ready. I've got a data set from a filtration experiment, and the goal of the experiment was to maximize the filtration rate by finding the optimum combination of the four factors: temperature, pressure, concentration of formaldehyde, and steering rate. And the experiment was designed as a two-level full factorial design, resulting in 16 individual runs. This here is the design plan saved in an Excel file. We have the four factors here in these columns, and each row represents an experiment with the filtration rate recorded in the fifth column here. And this data set we want to load into our Jupyter notebook so that we can start playing around with these different visualization techniques. Now, if you want to load a file, the easiest way is to just put it into the same directory as your Jupyter notebook file. Then you only need to specify the file name and not the complete path, including all subfolders. So that's what I have done. Let's ask our AI assistant for the code to load the data. Okay, we copy this part here because I already have the pandas package installed, so I don't need to install it. And I copy paste that into the Jupyter notebook file. And now I only need to specify the file name of my actual file here, which is this. Now I can execute this cell by hitting Shift Enter together. And now the data should be loaded in this df variable here. And now we can start playing around with it and create some plots. Let's start with main effects. And main effects are the effect of each factor individually. So basically what happens when you only change the temperature and keep all the other factors like pressure, steering rate constant. To calculate the main effects for a full factorial design as we have here, you basically compare averages. For example, let's say we are looking at temperature and we want to know what effect changing the temperature has on the filtration rate. You take the average filtration rate from all the experiments where the temperature was set to the high level and then compare it to the average filtration rate from the experiments where the temperature was set at the low level. The difference between these two gives you the main effect of temperature on your process. So let's do that for our example. And we are going to ask our AI assistant how to do that in Python. Okay, so ChatGPT creates a function here that takes the whole data frame as an input, and then we need to specify the results variable column. That works since we only have one result column in this data set. If we had more, we needed to do some modification, but since we don't have multiple result columns, we can go ahead. Okay, so let's copy the code and paste it into our Jupyter file here and hit Shift Enter to execute the cell. And here we go with the main effect plots. And what we immediately see is that the pressure here doesn't seem to have a big effect on the filtration rate, and temperature seems to affect the filtration rate the most if we look at all these four main effect plots. But what we don't know yet is if this effect of temperature here, for example, might depend on another factor. For example, if the effect of the temperature is only great when, let's say, the steering rate is at the high level, and we can find that out with interaction plots. If there are interactions between two factors, then those are called two-way interactions. If there are interactions between three factors, those are called three-way interactions, and so on. In theory, those higher order interactions are possible. In practice, two main interactions are important, but the higher order the interaction, the less significant they become. So we're only going to look at the two-way interactions now. To figure out the two-way interactions, we compare the effect of one factor at different levels of another. For example, if you're looking at the interaction between temperature and steering rate, you check how the effect of changing the temperature differs when the steering rate is at its high level versus when it's at the low level. Similarly, as with the main effects, we just compare the averages for these different groups. So let's check the interaction between temperature and steering rate for our experiment. And ChatGPT suggests to use the Seaborn package, which in my opinion is a great idea. Seaborn is a very powerful package that makes creating interaction plots incredibly easy because of this hue parameter here. It allows you to add a third variable to your plot in addition to X and Y. For example, if you're analyzing the interaction between temperature and steering rate, you put the temperature on the x-axis, just like you did with the main effects. But now you also use the hue parameter to distinguish the effect of temperature at different steering rates. This way you can clearly see how the temperature affects the filtration rate depending on whether the steering rate is high or low. So let's copy the code and paste it over in our Jupyter notebook. Execute with shift enter. Oh, and now we're actually getting an error message because steering rate and temperature is not in index. And the problem here is that the column names in our data frame are not temperature and steering rate, they are T and RPM. So we need to change that here real quick. T and RPM. Execute again, and here we have the interaction plot for temperature and steering rate. And as we can see, the interaction is quite significant. If the steering rate is at the low level, which is illustrated by the blue color, a temperature change doesn't affect the filtration rate much. But if the steering rate is at the high level here, then an increase in temperature increases the filtration rate by round about 40 points. And that's quite significant. So let's also look at the five remaining two-way interaction plots. And similarly to what we had with the main effect plots, ChatGPT is again creating a function that takes the data or the data frame as an input variable along with the response variable. So let's copy that, paste it into our Jupyter notebook. This time we see the filtration rate is again specified as the results column here, so we can execute and we get the two-way interaction plots for all our parameters here. Parallel lines indicate that there's no interaction between the factors. So in this example, there's only an interaction between temperature and steering rate and temperature and concentration of formaldehyde, where again, increasing the temperature only has an effect at the low concentration, but not at the high. Now for the next two plots, the counterplots and the 3D plots, we actually need a model that we fit by using ANOVA. And I'm going to show you how to do that in my next video, so make sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss that. For this example, I have already created the model. Okay, so this time again, ChatGPT is creating a function that it's called counterplot, which takes the model as well as the data, and then the factors that we want to plot on X and Y, and the response variable. And then there's the number of points variable that is set to 100, and we can probably leave that without changing it. Okay, so let's try. So contour plots are like a map, but instead of showing elevations, they show you how your response variable changes across two factors. So here we have the concentration of formaldehyde and the temperature. the two factors that are plotted on the y and x axis, and then we have the filtration rate illustrated by different colors. And the same down here with the steering rate and the temperature, and again the filtration rate illustrated by different colors. And the closer that these lines here are together, the steeper the change in the response variable. For example, here the counter lines are packed. It means a small change in your factor actually has a big impact on the filtration rate. While when the counter lines are spread out more, like here, then the response changes more gradually. You can also tell how your factors interact by the shape of the lines. Like here, curved or wavy lines indicate an interaction. And on the other hand, if the lines are straight and parallel, it usually means that the two factors don't interact much. So we could actually try that if we instead the temperature plot the pressure here. And as you can see, the lines are not curved. And that's also what we saw previously in the interaction plots, that pressure and concentration of formaldehyde, that there was no interaction here. And that's also what we see in the counterplot. And what's also great about counterplots is that you can identify optimal conditions really at a glance. For example, that the maximum in this region here, where both the temperature and the steering rate are at their high level. But there is one thing that I don't like about counterplots, and that is that in these counterplots, you don't see the measure points. You only see the model that was fitted. And that's why I also like 3D plots, because within a 3D plot, you can actually visualize both the model on the one hand, but also check how the model fits to your actually to your measured values. So let's go ahead and create a 3D plot. Okay, this time again we have model and data as input, as well as we specify our x and y factors that we want to put on the x and y axis, as well as what the response variable is. And then we also have a number of points here that is relevant for the plane for the predictions. So let's copy paste code and execute, and here we go, a three-dimensional plot where we see the plane that visualizes the prediction of our model, and then we have the measured points also visualized within that 3D plot, and we see that it's actually a reasonable good fit, that the predictions are reasonably good. And that's really what I like 3D plots for. I put a link that contains the data and the code and everything into the video description. But there's one more thing before you leave. All these visualizations work really great if you have conducted a full factorial design. So watch this video next if you want to learn how to create a full factorial design in Python.